Hey guys! Last week I asked if I should do a video review of my last Vegan Cuts box and many of you were curious. So I'm doing one. Word of warning, I am not going to be forgiving in this review. This will be a straight up my opinion based on my taste as someone who used to be a big meat and cheese lover but has been vegan for almost 4 years now. Also, I'm sharing opinions from my boyfriend Davin, who is not vegetarian or vegan but tried all these things with me. So first thing is a card about all the stuff in here and a coupon that I'll probably never use. So straight into the recycling bin. Okay, next, popcorn, chipotle lime, which by the way is my favorite flavor for Gardein vegan chicken tenders, which sadly I haven't seen in stores for like 2 years. But how was the popcorn? It was pretty plain. Good if you like plain food, but for me, I feel like eating this popcorn wasn't worth the chewing effort or the issue of having to pick out the bits out of my teeth afterwards. Next up, Nugo Fiber Delish in orange cranberry, and I generally enjoy that flavor combination, so it should be pretty delish, right? No, it tastes overwhelmingly of orange zest. It was kind of gross. Texture-wise, it's not bad for a healthy granola bar thing, but not the taste. Not the taste. So after trying that one, I reached into the box with a mix of dread, hope, and anticipation and got greens powder? Really? You know that gets a zero. Ditto for the protein powder. Now these look promising. It's called I Heart Quinoa, like a cute spelling of the food. They are little clusters with chocolate drizzled on top, and they are sweet and salty. Too bad they almost broke my teeth. They are super hard. Dav said they weren't bad though. He did say that he thought the texture would go better with a maple syrup taste, but I think maybe that's his Canadian-ness contaminating his opinion. I didn't like them at all though. So far, this box was getting pretty lame. When I saw this Go Veggie Parm, I immediately checked the ingredients, even though Vegan Cuts, of course, has pre-screened all these products, but paranoid me needed to double check. So it is vegan friendly and tastes like what I think cheapy Kraft Shaker Parm tastes like. It's been so long. We put it on popcorn to improve the flavor, which did make the popcorn more snackable. But to give it a fair shake, the next day I made a pasta bolognese to give the parm a more real-life test. And yeah, we conclude it's pretty okay. It's the closest vegan parm that I've had or Dav has had compared to the dairy stuff. Personally, I'd much rather have the taste of walnut/pine nut based parm. I think it tastes better, and you get the benefits of eating nuts as well. Next up, a snack bar. I was pretty impressed with this tiny ingredient list, but sadly, I didn't like it. The apricot bits reminded me of preserved fruit, that, you know, the kind of Christmas cake, and the ratio of coconut shreds to everything else was just too much. It was hard to swallow, literally hard to chew and swallow. But Dav didn't mind it. He said it was okay. Next, we have some tea. You guys know I love my tea, especially herbal tea. This one is called Miracle Tea, and it's made from moringa leaves. There are a bunch of claims here saying it's anti-inflammatory, full of antioxidants and amino acids. Wow, guys. You know what else has these things? An apple, lettuce, strawberries, kale. Anyways, I tried all three flavors and they taste basically like crap. Like lightly swampy swamp water, which maybe has a hint of unripe fruit. These next things were exciting. Beanitos! I wanted to try these as I've seen them in other people's videos and they seem to like them. Plus, I love beans. For me, it was a bit conflicting. I like the flavor, but not the chip. They taste like a healthy, whole grain baked version of a junk food. But if you look at the nutrition values, they're not much different at all. Dav said they look like little discs of dried poop. But he also said that they tasted good, so far as toasted carpet heavily dosed with barbecue seasoning goes, and he did finish most of the bag, so there's that. Next, a spice sample. Okay, I'm not sure why you're in my snack box, but okay, I'll use it eventually, probably, maybe. And lastly, we have an energy drink. It should taste good, I mean it looks like soda, but it tastes like orange zest and carrot juice and weird herbal stuff. Not a drink for fun times, my friends. But you know what else gives you energy and tastes good, actually? Oranges and orange juice. So overall, it was not great, but I have really enjoyed some of the boxes in the past. In the spirit of full disclosure, before receiving this box, I had already unsubscribed from Vegan Cuts. After reading all your comments in the last review and really thinking about my values and what I want to encourage with my limited voting dollars, I couldn't justify it to myself anymore. It's the excess packaging that is my main thing. Now, everyone creates waste and contributes to pollution, and I am no different. but this is very unnecessary to me. But that's just my opinion. What's yours? Tell me I'm crazy. Please share it in the comments below. Thanks for watching, and bye for now.